Hi everyone, today we will be creating a class. So I'm in transaction code SC24. The name of the class is ZCL parent class. So let's click on create. Let's remove this final checkbox and click on save. Local object. Attributes. Let us create attr pub, attr pro, attr pry. Level is instance attribute. Visibility is public for the first one, second one protected, and the third one is private. Now the associated type, let's give it a string because it's a sample stuff which we are doing. In the methods, let's do meth pub, meth pro, and meth prime. Level is instance. Visibility, let's select public, protected, and private, and let's click on save. Let's activate all these things. In the public method, let us write in public method, save, in protected method, and in private method, and let's click on activate once again. Now let's open a SE38 and let's create a program ZTMM called parent. Executable program. Here data LR parent type ref to ZCL parent class. So there is no syntax error. Now in the pattern, let's come over here and let's create an object LR parent ZCL underscore parent class. So what it will do is it will create an object of parent class. Now we will try to call all three methods over here of the same class. So LR parent method public pattern method pro and pattern method private, and let's click on check. So what it will do is it will give you an error for method which is called protected. That is because only public methods are available to be called outside the class or its subclass. Same is the case with the private method also. So this method is not available to be called inside the from any external program or other class which is not a subclass of this class. So I'll activate it and I will execute this. So what it will do is it will write this statement in public method. So now what I will do is I'll put a breakpoint over here and let's execute it. Now, if you see this object LR parent, let's see it in debugging. So if you see, there are methods which are attributes which are available, which is protected, private, and public. Okay, and when I execute this method, what it will do is it will go inside this public method pub, and write the statement and then come out. Now, if I try to access the public attribute again, LR parent hyphen ATTR PUB. Now let's just select this and let's do PRO and PRI for public. So this is public attribute, protected attribute, and private attributes. Let's do Control F2. Again, it will give you the same error message that there is no attribute for which is ATTR Pro and private. However, in the debugging, we just saw those attributes are still available over there. That is because these attributes are not accessible in the external class or any program which calls this class. Now, if I again, let's put a breakpoint over here and execute it. If you let's click on this parent. Now, this is the object. And if you scroll over here, you have pro protected, which is in orange, private red, and public. So whatever is highlighted over here in green only will be accessible outside the to the external program, function module, or you know, any other class which is calling this object. So we will see now. Let's come back. And in SE24, in the public method, let us try to call the protected and private methods over here. So let's select this ABAP objects. Now instance will be me because I'm calling within this class in the public method. ZCL parent class. And we will call the protected method and then again ABAP objects. We will call the private method and here we will write a statement calling the protected method. And then copy the same thing and paste it over here and write calling the private method inside the public method and inside the public method. Okay, and activate it. Again activate it and let's now go to this program again and execute this program. So if you see over here, this program is calling the public method. Let's do a FI and see what happens. Now we have gone in the public method. It will print in the public method. Then it will print calling the protected method inside the public method. Now it will go inside the protected method and it will print this statement in the protected method, calling the private method and then again the private method and we'll execute it. So if you see, First, it is in the public method. Then it called the protected method inside the public method. And this protected method statement got called. And then it called the private method inside the public method. And then the private method is called.